amarrados ahí, tú.
So we don't do that often, but once in a while the grapes come in, not to our liking, and they're dusty. And we like to freshen them up a little bit, wash them with reverse osmosis water, so if the water actually gets in the wine, it doesn't hurt it. And that's what we're doing right now. This is from our estate, it's our Merlot, and it's by the side of the road where we got a little too much dust for my liking. So we're going through the process where we dump the grapes and we wash them before we actually gonna go sort them. So we'll see you in a minute where we're sorting the grapes and you can see that part. Those are the three kind of things we tend to pull from the grapes when we sort them. Of course, our machine does a great job at pulling a lot of it, but we always like to add a human touch and making sure that we remove anything that the machine has not caught. We pull grain berries, because we don't want these in the wine. We pull berries that are not as mature as the others. That happens once in a while in certain vintages. And we pull raisins and jacks. Those are the three things we tend to pull from the berries. So we have about 7 or 8 sorters sorting at about 3/4 ton to a ton an hour, no more. Very slow sorting. So we make sure that I'm working with clean berries that don't have anything that impart any flavor that we don't want in the wine. So we work very hard, of course, in the vineyard, trying to dry farm, trying to stress the vines so that the fruit arrives here. It's very wrinkled, it's very concentrated. There isn't a lot of juice in the berries to start with. But to add to that, we perform a saigné where we routinely pull about 20% of the juice before the juice has lost it became red and basically sucked up all the color. We pull out about 20% of the juice and dump it in the drain. So we're getting pretty close to the end of harvest, and the wines are starting to dry up, and very soon they will be barrel. And one of the techniques I'm going to be showing right now is a technique that's a traditional French technique, really aimed at extracting soft tannins that come from skin versus from seeds. Seed tannins tend to be a lot harsher, they tend to bite more, while skin tannins tend to be a lot softer, more voluptuous, more silky. They allow a big wine to be enjoyed immediately after release, but it will also improve with time. So while most winemakers will end when the wine goes dry, I'll actually start creating the profile of the wines that I craft when the wine goes dry, which is a little bit of a different technique. So for instance, this tank right here is dry. And right now we're gonna start the process that's called warm macerating the wine. In other words, wine is sitting on skins, and we're going to heat up the tank to 89 degrees, sometimes up to 3 weeks, extracting and breaking down the skin tannin so that in fact the voluptuous tannins that are present in the wine will be extracted from all the skin. Right after that, we will drain the wine without pressing any wine, and that will basically make up what the Dow red wines are. 100% of all our red wines are made out of free run. In other words, we do not use any press wine. But we perform about 3 weeks, up to 3 weeks of warm maceration to really build up the skin tannin of the wine and give it structure and elegance versus just fruit and alcohol. So here we are at the end of harvest, a long harvest. It's been a great harvest. We love the wines that we made this year, and we're just about to give a home to all the wine that we made. The wines are dry. They've been they've gone through warm maceration. They're tasting beautiful, and now they're going to go into our nice, newly French oak barrels, and they're going to stay there for upward of 16 to 20 months until we basically bottle them and you can enjoy them on your table. And thank you for following us through this journey the last 2.5 months or so, and look forward to seeing you very soon.
Harvest was done, 2011.
It's not over.
2011,
harvest. Yeah. Tonight we are here to celebrate the end of the 2011 harvest. I cannot be more thankful to have an A-plus team like all these folks right here. And this is my team. They've worked very hard throughout the last 3 months to craft these wonderful wines. And today, tonight is their night. We're going to celebrate all their dedication and their hard work and their labor of love that they all have, all focused on the wines that we made this year. Thank you guys. Thank you very much.
Cheers. Cheers.
And it goes like this. Take me by the tongue and I know you. Kiss me till you're drunk and I show you. I got the moves like Jagger. I got the moves like Jagger. I got the moves like Jagger.
Daniel, a lot of work. Just joking.
Everything that I know in the winery is from Daniel. He's always checking over my shoulder, making sure I'm doing everything, checking, asking me if I'm argon in tanks, and, you know, washing the valves. So, you know, he's really making sure that I get everything done, and it's been a real fun. He really works well, he works hard, and it's definitely shown with the wine that we make.
I think Brian was special about the harvest. I'm just going to go out there. I'm just going to go out there and say it.
She's
never a dull moment when,
if
you were ever tired. Hey, Brian, show us a move.